Choppin' It Up with Starsheer and co-host Frankie.
Fingers.
Yeah, I call you Frankie Frank, and I call you Frankie Fingers too. But her name is Frankie Fingers, y'all. We're here.
It's at The Real Frankie Fingers on Instagram if y'all want to follow me.
We're here with Richard Meyers, Esquire.
Or Myers.
The third.
Listen, my English is not very good looking sometimes.
Oh, my English is not very good looking.
And he's here. You know, he's going to chime in back and forth. We got Alfie, the president of Flowhio Radio, and
Surge in general. Sergio.
The CEO.
The guy basically led every single show on the Flowhio Radio Network.
Yep. So today we have a special guest. And it's going to get really juicy in here. But first, Frankie, anything new?
Yeah. We're going to talk a little bit about what happened this week. I know it's going to get into the... It's got to do with what we're going to talk to today about today, actually, a little bit. It's weird.
There's a tie-in.
It's fucking weird. Oh, I mean, it's not a huge tie-in. That's what she said. That wasn't funny. But anyways...
It was funny to me, Frankie. It was funny to me.
So... I'm working, right? I'm done with the service. I'm looking at my client. I'm like, yo, do you like your haircut? He's like, yeah, it's good. Okay. So we're talking, right? And I like to make direct eye contact, especially with my first-time clients. You know what I mean? I want you to know that I see you, right? I see you. Okay. Dude, I shit you not. This man looks me straight in the face, and he goes, go like this.
Oh,
I said,
wait. What? Let me turn it around.
Oh, yeah.
Let me turn it around.
He goes,
what do you do?
He goes, do this. I'm like, what? And he's like, oh, you know you want to. I said, nigga, if you don't get fuck out of here. Fuck no. I didn't do it. He was like, oh.
I would have been like.
Nah. Hell no.
Gotta get that tip.
Make sure it reflects in the tip. Thank you.
Oh, my Lord.
Crazy thing about that was his card got declined.
Oh!
Yeah.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Well, honey.
Two rejections.
No
back
money,
to back.
No honey.
No.
He was trying to flirt his way out of it.
No money, no honey. Yeah.
No wonder. He said, let me do this so she can feel bad for me. I don't have to pay for the haircut.
I don't feel bad for nobody.
Now, tomorrow when I get to work, I'm going to look at the list of appointments that we had today.
I don't even. No, it wasn't today. It was the other day.
Which I've been day holding was it?
She ain't gonna say it now.
I don't remember.
Since I like to get a visual of the person.
It wasn't.
Damn. pictures.
Yeah. Who we got in the studio today?
We're gonna talk about a little bit about pictures. You know, with the ones we send to people on our phones and stuff.
I never done that.
You have never sent a naughty picture to anybody?
You can tell she has. She got just by
that
face.
Look at that face.
That was the most
don't
guiltiest.
Call me out.
No, we
sir,
saw.
Get
we saw you.
Here.
I sent a pic, naughty pics, to my ex, but we were living together.
Okay.
You know, and then when when we broke up, I was like, "Fuck, he has the pictures.
It's got the ammo."
But I am such a smart chick. Hallelujah. That I was like, yo, I'm going to confiscate that phone somehow. And I did, you know, because the phone belonged to my company. And I was able to get the phone. So
Wait, so you took dude's phone?
Uninvited. Like, I just was
but that don't mean
I need to go pick up my phone.
That don't mean anything.
You think they emailed it to them?
Of course. It's the first thing you do. You get a backup.
Damn.
Yep.
Yeah. Was it an iPhone?
I'm doing this game so wrong. Teach me, people.
Never send pictures.
I never send pictures, you know. But I get pictures sent to me, and I'm just like, why?
Wow.
Like, I don't remember you even, like, asking me out to dinner or something, you know?
So you require dinner before...
If you're going to send me...
It's a minimum requirement.
I don't even want to see it.
At least pay for a meal first.
Like, do I want to see it? Convince me that I want to
see
it.
Wait. What if that is the meal?
Huh?
What if...
Serge said you got to at least pay for a meal
for
us.
What
if that is the meal?
Ooh. Frankie.
All I'm saying is you never know nowadays, you know? Put it in a hot dog bun or something.
Dude. Yeah. Don't be sending us pictures later of your wiener in a hot dog bun.
Star said she wants all of them, please. At Star Shear, thank you.
Oh, fuck. That's because, you know, no, I'm not even going to have a contest about it.
We will put your shit face out there, so at your own discretion. I just want you to know.
Yeah, do not. If you're not embarrassed. I mean,
you better be proud of it.
You better be proud of it. So
same
today,
shit, fam.
She doesn't want wieners, she wants cocks.
Excuse me.
That's I don't like that word.
That word sounds wieners? So cruel.
This is the second time that somebody said that. Yeah,
it makes me uncomfortable. It's like saying penis.
It's like an animal.
Like if the word penis makes me uncomfortable.
Ybor City has cocks.
A lot of cocks
yes. In Ybor City. Little cocks, big cocks, old cocks, young cocks.
Vienna sausages.
You don't like cocks?
That's
is that what they call it nowadays?
The cocks with the claws.
Cocks with the claws.
Oh, so, gosh. Since we're talking about this, I decided, you know, I wanted to talk about it. Because I think it's funny that people don't really do the seduction thing anymore. You know what I mean? Like, people just, like, send people pictures and then it's like, okay, well, yeah, what's next? Like, okay, well, oh, nice, and that's it. Like, what do you say?
Has that ever worked? Have
you ever lied? Like, usually the pictures... Listen. Hear me out. Usually the pictures come attached with some sort of comment, right? You get like, oh, you like that?
You like this,
oh,
don't you?
It's big, ain't it?
You like this big cock, don't you?
But have you ever lied and been like, oh, yeah, it's so big when dude's out here with a fucking Vienna sausage?
Yes. No, Mina, I'm not gonna even lie because I don't even like those, and I always like I be dodging the bullet, like, you know, I be trying to change the conversation real fast, really, and then they'll be like, bling, like, damn, why'd you have to do that?
Hey, so say all that again so everybody on the show can hear it next time.
Okay,
what do
but
you
if
mean?
You want to send an artistic one?
No, I was just talking to her, fucking with her, because you ain't talking into the mic.
Yeah, we have a surprise. We have a really good surprise. But, yeah, like, why can't you just wait? I don't know. You know, because sometimes when you like somebody, you can see past some stuff that you may not accept before the picture.
Sure. Yeah. Sure.
Are you going to give us examples now?
Yeah, Star. Let us know.
Yes, please.
I mean, like.
Talk about it.
Oh, I don't know. But, like, you know, maybe we have a certain preference and we take, like, 3% less than what we would be happy with, just if the person's nice and does everything right, you know.
Yeah we know.
I don't know. I think guys think, you know, I don't know what guys think, but girls don't think any different because they'll like send a picture to a dude and really not get back from it.
I think there's more sex appeal in a woman's body than there is in a man's dick.
Big facts.
Okay, there you go.
Like, we dude, you're literally showing me 4 inches of you. Right? And but when it comes to like when you turn around and be like, yo, like, you know, you're like, send me a picture, right? To the girl or whatever, someone you're talking to, right? Like, you expect some good quality shit, right? Like, you used to be able to pass up with like a little blurred face, like it's all blurry, you know. But it's like there's more appeal to a woman's body than there is in a man's body. So
facts.
I mean, at least that section, right? Because that's what you gonna send me, right? Like, I'm like, is that not what you're gonna sending, Richard?
Are all our heads nodding on radio?
I think, yeah, no, nobody can see it, but everybody is just agreeing very silently.
I don't know. Some people are very passionate, so they like things like in segments. Like, you can't just throw it all out there so quickly. It's like,
nah.
Oh, fuck.
My rule is if she hasn't put it in her mouth, she can't get it on the phone.
Wow. Is that really the rule?
Wow.
Facts. I'm not going to send you something you haven't seen already. What's the point?
Okay.
I'm just saying, like, facts. I mean, maybe for a reason it will be a good thing because you'll get to know. I don't know.
No. Nah.
But, like.
I'm not jumping on new.
Listen, sometimes it's just way too soon.
Yeah, no, wait, no.
Sometimes it's way too soon. It's just like. And then you have, like, Mr. over there doing like everything. You know what I mean? There's guys that put work.
That's
how
crazy.
Soon is way too soon?
I don't know. We're
going
to have to ask our guests in a little bit.
Okay. They have to have at
least seen
it.
More of a professional of us. See, the problem is we don't know the selfie game in, when it comes to that, and we're all failing. Everybody's failing because, you know, nobody's, like, really locking it up. Everybody's like, yeah, whatever.
I don't even send that. I don't do that.
You don't send no nudes? Let me make some phone calls.
I have before. I'm not going to lie.
I have before. No, he says he has.
Search
but like I said, they've had to have been introduced already.
Right. We got to be friends.
We got to be friends.
Okay, see, that's how I feel, too.
Like, if they haven't seen each other.
That's how I feel, too.
I'm not sending pictures.
But to be honest with you, I'm not asking for one.
Yeah.
Like, if, especially I never if I already it. Saw it.
Yeah, I never
like, I know it. That shit's ugly, motherfucker. Like, don't send it to me.
I've
seen it. And I don't want to look at it and then tell you how I feel about it.
I never send them unless they're requested.
Oh, I'm not asking for it, so you should just never send one.
Yeah.
Oh, I do want to do a quick PSA. I want to let every guy out there listening that we show your pictures to whoever.
Oh, absolutely. I bet.
100%.
But the guys do it, too. The guys show it to their girlfriends. I get guys showing me pictures of other girls.
Okay.
Why?
Because
why do you guys feel so comfortable?
They want us. They want us to be like, she's cute or not. I don't know.
Are we one of the boys?
Subconscious.
I would assume that they consider us part of the boys.
Yeah, girl barbers.
Yeah.
No wonder, because they'd be coming up and saying some crazy. I'm like, wow. I mean, I enjoy it. I enjoy it. You know, I love to learn. You know, the male mentality. It's nice to learn, you know?
I just think,
but like,
if you have a little wee-wee,
no wonder they don't ask us
don't
out
send
ever.
No pictures. Because I can count more place times than I can count the amount of times that somebody, some female friend, cousin, whatever, has shown me a picture of some dude that was like, LOL, look how tiny this man's dick is. Ha ha ha. And then we laugh
that's
about
tragic.
You. We laughing at you.
Remember that guy? Oh my God. So this happened. Let's talk about that guy that sent me those pictures and she was like, you're going to talk to him? I'm like, hell no.
Okay.
The guy from the truck.
Oh, Manny.
Wow,
this is a good story because I worked hard for this.
So I meet this guy at my job, right? And I'm over there, you know, just chilling. I'm walking in the back, and he runs to me, and he goes, I've seen you here before. I never got a chance to talk to you, but get my number. So he's all linked up, and I'm like, okay. So I'm like,
he was
okay.
Not ugly, no. He was not ugly.
And so I grab my number, and then I'm dialing the number, and he says, text me. So I was going to text him. My boss called me.
At that moment.
So he left, and then...
A couple of days. Oh, she comes inside and she tells me, right? She's like, you're not going to believe it. I met this guy. He was so hot. And I was going to get his number. And then I got a phone call and I lost his number. I was like, damn, he gone forever now.
Yep.
Like, we'll never know. Fast forward to like a week later, right? I walked to 7-Eleven because there's a 7-Eleven in the plaza that we work. And I'm looking at this dude and I was like, you kind of look like I've seen you before, but I've never seen this man before, right? Star is just that descriptive. So I'm sitting there and I was like, dude,
I'm very descriptive.
You look familiar. And I'm like, are you like Danny? And he's like, what? And I was like, what's your name? And he's like, I'm not telling you, right? He's one of those guys. So I'm like, okay, your name's like Danny or Manny or something. He's like, my name's Manny. And I was like, yo, listen, real quick. This girl I work with told me that she tried to get your number and then she lost it and she couldn't text you. And he was like, I was wondering what happened. So then I was all heroic, Captain Save-A-Ho over here. I got his number for Star. I ran to the barbershop. I was like, yo, you're welcome.
And my face is like, what the fuck just happened? Like, she's like running to me and I'm like, yo, me and Frankie were not that cool yet.
We really weren't.
You know what I mean?
I'm that kind of friend.
So just how long ago was this?
When like she first started months. Working there, like five months ago? Yeah.
So, we text and stuff like that, but he did it.
Oh, no.
He fucking did it.
He was like, I've been waiting months to send his dick pic.
Listen, he was sending me
his cock.
Like, he was like, hey, it wasn't even a fresh one. And he goes, send me a picture. That's an old one. And I said, what kind of picture? You know, we all say, what kind of picture?
Exactly.
And then he's like, oh, just like, you know, a headshot or something. So I'm like, why don't you just go on my Facebook? There's like 1,000 in there. And he was like, no, send me one right now. So I send him one, you know, and then he sends me that.
Manny, what are you doing, bro?
Manny. And guess what this bitch did?
Oh, boy.
Not even 30 seconds later, she runs up to me and she's like, yo, Frankie, look what this dude just sent me.
I didn't just show Frankie. I showed all the girls that work at our barbershop. I'm like, look.
Now, this is the same day that you got the number?
No, it happened. It was a transition.
Okay, I was about to say. Like, there's like an hour within it.
Like light speed.
So the same day that I really got his number, I text him and he texted me back and then told me send me a picture. I sent the picture. Then he went ham. And then he wouldn't stop texting me about weird shit. You know what I mean?
Manny, what are you doing?
I think he said something to him.
She's a freak.
Yeah.
Go get her.
Maybe that's what happened.
I didn't know.
It was so weird to me that he turned out to be like that because, like, he made it so hard, like, it was so hard for him to try to talk to me.
Yeah.
It happened by a miracle because he has seen me before so many times, you know? And finally, like, I was actually very close to the other side of the building that I was had enough time to walk, so he went all the way to the front and walked with me back to talk to me, you know?
So how did you handle it right after the picture? Did you, like, ignore him or what?
I said, I don't like people like you, and that's it.
Damn. That sucks. Well, how about we take a little break, listen to a little music, right? And we're going to have Jose Gomez.
Boom.
Let me tell you who Jose Gomez is.
Fine art. That's it. Fine art.
He is a nude photographer.
Well, photographer.
Okay. My vocabulary is fucked. He's a nude photographer. Right.
Boom.
Okay. And he is the king of nudes. He's the king. His work sells for like $800 and up pictures. Sheesh. So, you know, he's in there.
And Yahoo's sending this shit for free.
For free.
And then I'm going to tell you an experience. I shot nude for him. So we'll talk about that. I'll tell you how it went, how I felt. And then he will be on and, you know, share some on us about everything he's listening to us because we're not professional fucking nude photographers, but he is.
He's gonna give what happened. Don't worry about it. Here we go to play some music.
Hey.
Turn around, fuck it all the way up. Dust it down, turn around, fuck it all the way up. Bust it down, turn around, fuck
look. Let's get it straight, girl. You don't need a nigga for nothing. Looking better every day, you got that Benjamin Button. Claiming he don't got a girl, you know niggas be frontin'. You don't need no bitch coming up to you as a woman. Ayy, and you a boss, so you hate when niggas waste time. You too pretty to be paused on the FaceTime. Damn, I'm just stating the facts. You hate that like you hate when niggas tell you relax.
The fuck you mean relax?
You want something more than just physical. Word. It been a while since you met someone original. Word. You spend your time drinking wine in your living room. All that good pussy can't find the one to give it to.
What?
It's a shame. You see me, see the squad, it's a game. You see him, it's a bum, it's a lame. But it's a difference between me and what's his name. I swear to God, word to Mace. Ay. I'ma drink this Henny to the face. Ay. Fuck a condom, I'ma bring some rain wrap. I can't let no good pussy go to waste. Ay. Back, backing it up. I'm the king of talking shit, then backing it up. Ay, back, back, backing it up. Throw that shit over here, girl, that's what it's for.
What you say?
You know how to go and get a bag, don't you? Ay. You know how to make a bitch mad. Don't you? Make your ex wanna get it back, that's a fact.
back. Say a lot of for the bitches in the back. Hey.
I know how to go and get a bag, don't I? I know how to get a bitch mad, don't I? Make my ex wanna get it back. That's a fact. Say a lot of for the bitches in the back. Hey. Back, back, backing it up. I'm the queen of talking shit, then I'm backing it up. Yeah. Back, back, backing it up. Throw that money over here, nigga, that's what the fuck. Said I was getting some head, getting some head. Ran down on a bitch, she almost pissed on her leg. Bitches think they fucking with me, must be sick in the head. Why don't you chill with the beef and get some chicken instead? Got the crown, shut it down, had it hype up in the six. If she dead, let her lay, won't bring no life into this bitch. Again, this girl should be a sin, you should call me Cinnamon. Cardi B, bad bitch, those is fucking synonyms. We see who winning, we see who got it. You see I'm still in the back, making deposits. You see who switched up sides and who was solid. You see who stuck to the code and who forgot it. Talk about it, bitch.
You know how to go and get a bag, don't you? You know how to make a bitch mad, don't you? Make your ex wanna get it back, that's a fact. Say a lot of for the bitches in the back, ayy.
I know how to go and get a bag, don't I? I know how to get a bitch mad, don't I? Make my ex wanna get it back, that's a fact. Say a lot of for the bitches in the back, ayy.
Back, back, backing it up. I'm the king of talking shit, then backing it up, ayy. Back, back, backing it up. Throw that shit over here, girl. That's what it's for.
What you say?
Yo, I never fucked Wayne, I never fucked Drake. All my life, man, fuck's sake. If I did, I'd menage with him and let him eat my ass like a cupcake. My man fool, he just ate. I don't duck nobody but tape. Yeah, that was a setup for a punchline on duct tape. Worry about if my butt fake. Worry about y'all niggas are straight. These girls are my sons, John and Kate. Plus eight, when I walk in, sit up straight. I don't give a fuck if I was late. Dinner with my man on a G5 is my idea of an update. Hut, hut one, hut, hut two. Big titties, big butt two. Fuck with them real niggas who don't tell niggas what they up to. Had to show bitches where the top is. Ring finger where the rock is. These hoes couldn't test me, even if their name was Pop Quiz. Mad bitches who I fuck with. Mad bitches we don't fuck with. I don't fuck with them chickens unless they last name is Cutlet. Let it soak in like seasoning. And tell them bitches blow me. Lance Stevens.
Raise every bottle and cup in the sky. Sparks in the air like the 4th of July. Nothing but bad bitches in here tonight. Oh, if you lame and you know it, be quiet. Nothing but real niggas only. Bad bitches only. Rich niggas only. Independent bitches only. Boss niggas only. Thick bitches only. I got my real niggas here by my side. Only.
I never fuck Nikki cause she got a man. But when that's over, then I'm first in line. And the other day in her Maybach, I thought, goddamn, this is the perfect time. We had just come from that video. You know, LA traffic had a city slow. She was sitting down on that big butt, but I was still staring at the titties, though. Yeah, low key and maybe high key. I been peeped that you like me, you know? Who the fuck you really wanna be with besides me? I mean, it doesn't take much for us to do this shit quietly, I mean. She say I'm obsessed with thick women, and I agree. Yeah, that's right. I like my girls BBW. Yeah, type that wanna suck you dry and then eat some lunch with you. Yeah, so thick that everybody else in the room is so uncomfortable. Ass on Houston, Texas, but the face look just like Claire Huxtable. Oh, yeah. You the man in the city when the mayor fuck with you. The NBA players fuck with you. The badass bitches doing makeup and hair fuck with you. Oh. That's cause I believe in something and I stand for it. And Nikki, if you ever try to fuck, just give me the heads up so I can plan for it.
Raise every bottle and cup in the sky. Hey. Sparks in the air like the 4th of July. Nothing but bad bitches in here tonight. Oh, if you lame and you know it, be quiet. Nothing but real niggas only. Bad bitches only. Rich niggas only. Independent bitches only. Boss niggas only. Thick bitches only. I got my real niggas here by my side. Only.
I never fuck Nick and that's fucked up. If I did fuck, she'd be fucked up. Whoever is hitting ain't hitting it right, cause she act like she need dick in her life. That's another story, I'm no storyteller. I piss greatness like gold is yellow. All my goons so overzealous. I'm from Holly Grove, the holy mecca. Calendar say I got running for days. I sperm and I shake, but I'm stuck in my ways. My girlfriend would beat a bitch up if she waved. They better not fuck with her surfboard. Surfboard, my eyes just so bright, I take cover for shade. Don't have my money, take mothers instead. You got the hiccups, you swallow the truth. Then I make you bird boy. Creepy flex, Sirloin, I'm talking about running in houses with army guns. So think about your son and daughter rooms. Got two hoes with me, messed up, they got smaller guns. Ain't thinking about your son and daughter rooms. This shit is crazy, money. I've been praising my nigga, that money talk, I just rephrasing my nigga. Blood gang, take the B out, behavior, my nigga. For reals, if you mouth off, I blow your face off. I mean, then I take off. Nigga, now you see me, nigga, now you don't. Like Jamie Foxx, acting like Ray Charles. 16 in a clip, one in a chamber. 17 wall bullet with 17 bullets. My story is how I went from poor me to police pour me a drink and celebrate with
praise
me.
Every bottle and cup in the sky. Sparks in the air like the 4th of July. Nothing but bad bitches in here tonight. Oh, if you lame and you know it, be quiet.
Young Moolah, baby.
Nothing but real niggas only. Bad bitches only. Rich niggas only. Independent bitches only. Boss niggas only. Thick bitches only. I got my real niggas here by my side. Only.
I know you're gonna do it for the grand, right?
DA got that dough. Yeah.
First things first, I fuck, get all the money. Bitches love me, keep it honey. Bitches like you, cause you funny. Niggas ain't stunners. I'm the one that came and fucked the summer. I got a black Barbie, she into menages. I'ma fuck her all night till I come nothing. Sip got me buzzing, I am not a husband. I could be your daddy cause I am a motherfucker. Fuck niggas muggin', these niggas sweet muffin. Put my seed on her face, she get smashed like a pumpkin. Ooh, she love it, do me rougher. Talk that nasty, when I smack your ass cheek. Can you make a dip,
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 make a dip. Here, baby, take a sip,
take a sip,
take a sip,
take a sip.
Lick a lip,
lick a lip.
Yeah, baby, I just wanna see you dip,
see you dip.
Make a dip,
make a dip,
make a dip,
make a dip,
make a dip. Yeah, baby, take a sip,
take a sip,
take a sip,
take a sip,
take a sip.
Hey,
yeah, baby, show me how you make it dip.
The tippy, then put it on my lippy. Even when it gets sticky, he know it still got the drippy. Yeah, I'm pulling your card though, got him calling me Vicky. All these bitches my minis, got him calling me Mickey. All that rah-rah never was the icon issue. Harper's Bazaar, I'm covering the icon issue. I got issues, yeah, bitch, I got issues. W, Vogue, Cosmo, I got issues. Pull up with some Barbie dolls, sticking the thighs. I said we looking for some brain with the wick of the eyes. Last nigga was a dope dealer, hell of a guy. He said the pussy top.
Can you make a dip,
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 make a dip.
Here, baby, take a sip,
take a sip,
take a sip,
take a sip.
Lick a lip,
lick a lip.
Yeah, baby, I just wanna see you dip,
see you dip.
Make a dip,
make a dip,
make a dip,
make a dip,
make a dip.
Yeah, baby, take a sip,
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 take a sip.
Yeah, baby, show me how you make a dip.
Santana bandana on the twist. Got your bitch wave riding on my dick. Many niggas ain't shit. I done came back with the hits, fresher than the pillow with the fucking mint. What I said, I meant, yeah. This shit is big, yeah. I came to flex, yeah. Look in the mirror, yeah. Look at your ass, fuck a career, yeah. How you make a G-string just disappear? She like, buy me other shit, I need bags, I need fits, I need cash, I need cash, I'm just really nigga rich. Make it splash, but before I get you drip, I just got one question, bitch.
Can you make a dip,
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 make a dip.
Here, baby, take a sip,
take a sip,
take a sip.
Take a sip,
lick a lip,
lick a lip.
Yeah, baby, I just wanna see you dip,
see you dip.
Make a dip,
make a dip,
make a dip,
make a dip,
make a dip.
Yeah, baby, take a sip,
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 take a sip.
Yeah, baby, show me how you make it
dip. What's poppin' 10? I'm deposit 10. All these ends, why you motherfuckers got to
be?
All this cops again. Eat a box or something. I start your little watch with some rocks or something.
What poppin'?
What's poppin'? Make a dip, make a dip, make a drop again. Me a bumpy dog, got it doing lock again. West side, we tiger up in the pocket again. Who got the juice? Be sending you niggas crazy. Who got a man like me and that pussy wavy? Me, I had to dash like damn baby on Stacy. When you turn them down, these clowns turn into babies. Who got the juice? Be sending you niggas crazy. Who got a man like me and that pussy wavy? Well, these niggas want me to love them like I'm Kiki. Got them in their feelings since they see me in Fifi.
Oh.
so you can run and tell back, homeboy.
Welcome back.
Ew. So, Star, I can't get it out of my mind. So, yeah, I know. But tell me about these nudes, these professional nudes that you took. How nude were you? Like coochie on the carpet nude, or?
Listen, I was like totally.
Will we
totally
know when you release these photos?
I mean, there's going to be things you're going to see, but yes, I took complete nudes. Like complete nudes.
Butt ass naked.
Like totally.
You brave, because
like maybe in one shoot maybe had some string involved, I don't know, and some other shit. What? You know?
No.
So yeah, I did nudes. But I did
Wait.
Nudes.
Wait. Oh, go ahead. Sorry. Hmm? Tasteful, yeah, tasteful nudes. Me. We've decided that they're tasteful.
I didn't do just regular nudes. I did fine art nudes.
Fine
it's
art
a different
nudes.
Caliber.
Now tell the people out here, Star, you selling them nudes?
Well, they may be up for sale.
Hey, if some of y'all are weird motherfuckers.
Because I signed this paper that says, like, I signed these papers when I took these nudes.
Alfie?
And it's his property?
No, I signed this paper when I did these nudes, and, you know, the photographer that signed me on for them said to me this. Whatever money I make, you will get royalties for the rest of your life.
Whatever money he makes.
Yes. Yep. Off okay. my nude.
Cutting that check.
So then I said, wow. The rest of your life. This is the real deal. You know, there's so many photographers out here in the industry, because I don't know if you guys do not know this, but I've been in the Florida creatives for the last like 8 years. Runway shows, photo shoots, a lot of collaborations in this industry. You know, and I know so many photographers that are not photographers and just going to take pictures because they want to see you naked, and they're not going to try to take it to the next level, or you're not making money with it, because when you are modeling, you want to make money. Why are you going to model and not make money? You want a security, and everybody's in their business, and it takes a investment of time sometimes, and then you got to sell them. Like, there's a business about it. And some people are not that talented. And yeah, with the autographs and stuff like that, you know, they're just doing it to get you. But there are those real photographers that earn the business of photography.
Ooh.
That make money for it because that's what they do for a living.
Right, right, right. So we got one in this very, very, very studio. Why did I say very so many times? I don't fucking know.
A very, 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 very,
very,
very.
We got a fine art photographer here. Jose, tell us about you.
Hey, guys. What's going on? I appreciate you guys inviting me on the show.
Yeah, no problem, man. Yeah. Now, I've never, obviously we meet photographers, right? But I've never met someone who does the kind of photography that you do. It's why? Like, why nudes?
Well, nudes is something that I think a lot of photographers would love to be able to do them. I think that it's a natural inclination to want to photograph the female or male form, to find expression in that. Of course, some people just want to shoot naked people, but
right.
I think also too there's a mixture of self-expression, but then also inherently your sexuality and showing, you know, what you are, expressing who you are in a way that you normally can't do.
Right.
And normally, like when you know, we're talking about like selfies and sending people, you know, naked yeah. pictures, that's one way of expression. And then there's kind of the more curated version of that, the more shadowed and the more expressive version of that. It's a little bit more intentional. So I love that side of photography.
Yeah. Now, do you work with a lot of people who already know what they're doing, or do you have a big role in artistically aside from the photography?
Yeah, that's an important question. I did fashion for, you know, over 10 years. And fashion's a little bit of a different world because you're working with usually models that know what they're doing. In my world, it really doesn't matter. Usually, the models that are experienced are harder to work with than the people who aren't, because they've already got their go-to poses and they've right. got the things that in their mind look good. but they're really not trying to express until you kind of get them into the process, and they kind of lose all that, and they just become themselves.
Well, it's pretty difficult once you've been doing something, you know, for years, if this model is significantly experienced, that, you know, for to be able to let go of something that you've been doing for so long.
And letting go is important.
This isn't like editorial. No. Right? You're not shooting for a magazine.
You're shooting for yourself.
Different. Right.
You know, in my style, it's very organic, and it's very much a collaboration. So I might come with feelings and emotions that I want to attach, because the reality is that's what me as an artist is trying to pick up on. I'm trying to capture the emotion of what I'm trying to do so that people can connect to the individual image that might be hanging in a gallery, it might be hanging in a museum. But you as a person has to bring that out. You got to find something within yourself that you can attach and connect to that, and use nudity and your own, again, whether it's natural expression all the way to very sexual expression, you can find you in what we're doing. So really you're shooting for you. You're not shooting for somebody else.
Nice.
So I want to just put in, I just want to let everybody know what the experience with me was with Jose when I shot with him. We've met each other so many times throughout all these events that we go to, and I've seen him. I've done work for his wife before, his ex-wife, and which is a lovely person. And so that's how I met him. I always saw him all these runway shows, and you know, he was always that one. Like, you were like, who is he? You know what I mean? So I finally got to meet him, and then I started talking to him. We always talk, you know. We always have, you know, everybody. We network a lot. And he reached out to me and he said, "Are you ready?" And I said, "Yep." And I went to his studio, and yes, I was freaking out. You know what I mean? But the thing with working with Jose is, like, you know, it's not like you just go in there and you start shooting nudes. I went in there and, you know, I was like, there's a room that he had set up for it. Very professional. Very professional. And we talked. And, like, he got my game up. You know what I mean? And he coached me through it. It was nothing creepy about it, because, you know, there was nothing, because this is work and we're going to work this. And he showed me his vision, and I told him what my vision was. And then, you know, he led me through it because he understood me. And, you know, we just took some great pictures. And I was like, wow, Jose, like, you know, I was fucking naked there.
You were great. You were great. You were really good. You know, you came in completely nervous. I don't know if you had to take a few shots before you did it or what, like most people do. You know, a lot of people come in, and I was just saying, you know, about, you know, working with experienced models versus people who are just people that I meet or friends. Listen, I've even shot friends nude. And it's really just an honor to see people just kind of let go. And part of my artistic process is really getting to know the person, so that during the shoot we can make it about them. So Star and I got a chance to just kind of get to know each other a little bit. I don't know, we talked for like half hour, 45 minutes is bullshit, and then we just figured out how to move that into step by step something that she could express herself through. And that for me is like the most important thing, making you feel comfortable, making sure that everything is just right so that you can feel the freedom that you need to feel.
And it was a very big experience for me. Like, it's a different world. It totally is a different world. Like, I'm here being naked, and it's a form of art, you know. And for him to have invited me over was already like, wow, Jose Gomez, just hit me up. So, you know, that was awesome. But, you know, like, everything he does, like, when you look at his pictures, like, you feel it. Like, they're naked, but it's not naked. Like, it's just different. Like, it has a different feeling to it, and you can totally connect to what you're seeing. That's why they're selling for, like, $800 a piece and up. That's crazy. People in Europe are buying this stuff. Like, what? So, you know, and, you know, that's his job. Like, that's what he does for a living. He's all over Tampa. And everywhere, Orlando, like, tell us where you go. Tell us.
Yeah. Well, most of what I do is that, you know, folks usually come to me. I'm right on Del Mabry in Tampa, right in the middle of Tampa by Bush. And people come over, they shoot at the studio. Every once in a while I do on-location stuff, but most of the time it's in a private setting, in a corporate office. We're going to be moving actually to West Columbus, so it'll be a little bit closer. But we've got a lot of stuff that we're doing. And what I love to do is create an environment where people feel good. So, Starves, if you remember, you know, when you came in, all the lights were on.
Yes.
All the companies, all the business, all the office lights were on. I want people to feel really interested and really safe and really comfortable. But as we start shooting, I just kind of turn lights off so it becomes more private, it becomes more intimate, it becomes a world that's yours. And yeah, so that's what I do. I try to kind of bring people over to my place, but every once in a while, if somebody's got a bedroom to use, we'll go shoot over there too.
Yeah, I was, you know, I was looking at your pictures on your Instagram, and there's so tastefully done. And I looked at it and I was like, wow, because I read your description. I was like, photographer, okay. And then I was like, nude. I was like, hold on. Nude. Like, in my mind, I'm picturing, like, yeah, there's people fucking having sex on this couch, and this guy is the guy holding the fucking camera. You know what I mean? But they're so tastefully done. Yeah. And in a lot of them, like, you're not looking at a body.
Right.
Like, it's weird to say like that. You guys really got to check them out. But it's, you're looking at someone, and it's like, for the most part, like, you're covered up. You just happen to be not wearing clothes. It's more about the making you think, like, what's here, rather than, like, hey, look,
yeah,
my nipples fucking drooping to the left. Like, right.
Yeah, it's not really about, like, the nude is the backdrop. It's the right backdrop for a bigger story. I have four themes that I shoot, and it's love, loss, pain, and pleasure. Those are the four themes that I try to capture. And then the fifth theme that's never named is really the person's individual story. So today, for example, I did a shoot, and today's shoot had a little bit of love, loss, pain, and pleasure, but then I also had movement, because a person's a dancer. So that fifth one is always theirs. It's always the thing that they like to do, the thing that they want to express, or maybe the thing that they've never expressed, that they're waiting for my 10x10 box of shadows to do that, you know, right. And they want to drape it a little bit, or maybe they want to be something that they've never been before, or maybe that they only rarely are, or maybe that they are only behind closed doors, and that's what they get the opportunity to do. Now, I got to tell you, though, I tell people, everything you can imagine has happened in my backdrop. I've changed right the paper since, I promise, but it's happened.
He says,
wow, that's crazy.
He says to me, I changed the paper. And you know, I know a lot of people. We're like in the same network, so I know a lot of models that shot for him. Like, I've, like, these people that he shot for him, like, I've done their hair for, like, a runway show, like, a photo shoot for his photo shoot. They'll come to me and I'll take care of them. Like, you know, we've done stuff like that. And, like, you know, with being comfortable in there is everything.
It really is.
Like, you know, that's like the thing that you think about. There's a lot of people out there that are going to be like, let's shoot a nude. And you really want to make it so bad and make money in this industry. And you go in there and you put yourself in a bad situation. You know what I mean? Don't mess with people that are not qualified for this. Pay a little money or have a collaboration that you're willing to do something this extreme and make some money out of it.
And start using your network too. You know, use people that you know. Meyers Law Firm will agree here that it's important to have the right documentation, the right contract in place. And, you know, one of the things that I do, it's a little different than most photographers, is that you don't release me to release every picture in your shoot. Mine is a conditional release.
Yes.
And it allows you per image, because I don't just release 200 mm-hmm images from your shoot. I release them one at a time, maybe over a period of 10 years. And it all depends on theme. It depends on a lot of things. But I always give the model the opportunity to see the image and to say either, I don't want it shown at all, like, thanks, but no thanks. Or, you know, just put it up on a wall, but I don't want to see it on social media. Or do it anywhere you want, just don't say that it's me. Or at the end of it, sell it to my mom, I don't care. You know, so they get the opportunity to determine that.
Where to you do you draw the line between, like, trashy, like, nude photo and, like, professional, like, classy, artful?
There's two pieces of the puzzle, I think, that make the difference. One of them is artistic intent. What's your intent? What are you trying to do? Now, that's that. You have to be careful with that, because sometimes even art is intended to arouse you. So it's not about arousal, but what's your intent personally?
Right.
And then the second thing is, what's the concept? What are you trying to portray? What are you trying to get across? What's the message that you're trying to bring across? One of the things that I love doing is, yeah, in my studio, there's been some pretty crazy things that have happened, but I'm never usually on the business end of that. I'm on the other side. I'm trying to capture the feeling of it. I'm trying to figure out, what is this person trying to convey to either the partner that's in the scene? Maybe they're alone, and maybe there's something going on there, but I'm trying to get in their head in a way that relates to the audience that's viewing the final image, but also in a way that intersects with me as an artist. Like, I'm like, can I relate to this? Right. So we might take 200 images, and out of those 200 images, one of those images collides with who I am, what I'm going through, that I know that connects with the audience that's going to see this, which primarily is female. So there's a lot of contingencies to what gets released.
Now, what of advice would you give to someone who maybe is a photographer, is amateur photographer, wants to get into it, and maybe never even considered the nude, you know, spectrum of photography? Yeah.
I'd say first, like, shoot other stuff. Like, don't immediately jump into nudes. It's really tempting to get a camera. We call those guys with cameras, GWCs. Guys with cameras, there's plenty of those. Guys with cell phones. Don't immediately jump into a nude genre. Start doing portraits. Start doing other types of people photography. But also try landscapes. Try street photography. Try fashion. Work your way into what you really like, because it sounds like nude photography would be something everyone wants to do, but once you start doing it, there's a lot of people that figure out it's not what they want to do. Sometimes there are relationship issues that are attached to that. Sometimes there's just a lot that comes with that. You got to be that person. Otherwise, go fucking shoot landscapes. Like, yeah. Leave that stuff alone. There's also, too, you got to examine your intent. If your intent is, and you've got issues in the area of sexuality, that's going to reflect in your artistic process. It's going to interfere with your professionalism. And at the end of the day, it could end you up in jail. So just keep yourself away from the things that will mess you up, and make sure that if you're doing new photography, you're doing it for the right reasons.
How long have you been a photographer, not just in the new genre?
I've been a photographer almost 20 years. So I've been doing this particular genre for about 4 years. Again, I did fashion for a really long time. And I really like it. I really like it a lot.
Okay, Jose. So now, where did you come from?
Where I came from?
Yes. Where are you from?
Like, I'm from originally from New York. You. Where else? There ain't no place.
Hello, New Yorkers in the house.
Glen Cove, New York.
Excuse me. We're from Long Island.
Oh my God.
Get the hell out of
besties
here.
Besties in the house.
Yes.
No, I went to summer camp at Fidel School.
They just listen. Strong Island.
There you go. That's what
Strong
I'm talking
Island.
About. Strong Island. Yeah. I was born in Glen Cove, resident in Seacliff, and then Central Islip, and then I made my way over to Spring Hill, Florida. So that
Why?
Was a big difference.
How
well, my parents
happen?
Moved. My parents moved.
So you came here as a young adult?
No, I was a young kid, actually.
Like,
so
how old?
It was like 1988, so.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Wow. I'm not even going
to
ask, Jose.
I didn't even make
Jose.
It out the 80s, man. I didn't even make it out the 80s to get over here. To Spring Hill, of all places.
Wow.
Which is like little New York now.
What was Spring Hill 30 years ago?
Oh, geez. Like, Spring Hill was nothing. Spring Hill was nothing. It was a bunch of, you know, a bunch of old people. We lived in West Spring Hill is where we
Jose,
lived.
Jose, how did you become this exotic capturing being?
I know, right? That's so interesting.
Like, growing up in Spring Hill.
Yeah. Well, you know what? I was always an artist. I used to draw. My big thing was music. I was a guitar player, and you know, had a rock band and the whole deal. And I was
the name
guy.
Of the band? What was the name of the band?
Oh, yeah. Name of the band. I had a few bands. Sanctification. We had another name. It was a rock metal band. That's what I played. Speed
wow.
metal. So we had a bunch of different names. But I did. I was a guitar player all my childhood, my teenage years, and.
Sorry, I'm having technical difficulties.
Stars, Mike is falling in her boobs, but right on theme. But yeah, I blew off a scholarship and ended up selling musical organs in Crystal River in a mall about as big as this room, and that's it. Move forward.
Pause.
Did you buy an organ?
You said musical organs.
What did you say before that?
What about?
You said something
about my scholarship.
Yeah. What did you get a scholarship in?
In music. I was gonna listen. I was gonna do that, and then I was gonna strap my guitar to my back and go to LA.
So why didn't you? What happened? Tell us.
Because I found myself selling musical organs in Crystal River, and then I said, you know, I know this little girl I dated and saw as a sophomore. I think I'll get in a car and go to Michigan and see what she's doing. And I married her 6 months later, and my life started, which deviated me from art to figuring out how to make a living because I had a kid 6 months later. So,
so like
you work fast.
So like
we're all doing the math. Here.
How does it feel?
Talking about the dating scene, I wasn't even a dater. I was right.
like, dude, let's get.
I was like, you. I'm marrying you now.
Okay, we're gonna start dating. How about that?
Well, you can certainly do that if you like.
Yeah, because now you know. How many people are single? Like more than the married ones, I think, because we're smart. Wow. But anyway,
shots fired.
Shots fired. Bam, bam, oh, no. Bam. Anyways, Jose, how did you feel? Like, okay, so you started the photography. What made you like say, let me start taking some pictures?
Well, I had a good reason. I was in a relationship that, you know, was very much about fashion. And I started shooting fashion very early, shooting run. Well, I got a camera first to shoot the runway for charity shows. Mm. Because we're finding difficulty finding photographers that we trusted to shoot at that time, you know, young girls that we were putting down the runway for charity reasons. And I loved it. Within months, I was already doing shoots and I learned my camera doing fashion.
But the whole time that you did this, you have your own career.
Right. I've got a marketing company at the same time. I'm starting at that time, and that's been going on for almost 20 years. We've had a great run, but I'm doing this as like my artistic outlet. And it was a lot of fun. It, you know, fashion's great, but fashion's a deadline-driven type of business. Mm-hmm. And right about 2011, I just, you know, I felt like my business was doing fantastic, my marketing company, and I just said, you know, I think I'm done with this. I don't need any more client deadlines. I had a client from hell situation. I gave that up. And then I gave up photography for a few years. When I came back, it was all about somebody contacted me to shoot, and I shot them. We did an artistic concept, and I realized, you know, what I hate is clients, not photography. And so I decided to just, let's do something artistic, something that doesn't have deadlines.
Nice. You know, I see you, Jose, and I'm like, you know, like, I'm a watcher. Like, you see me a lot around, and you always see me in your shows. Like, I'm like, you know, I go and scout. Like, I see people. And you were one of the people that always stood out to me.
Thank you.
You know,
It's the hair.
Hair. It's the and, hair for sure. You know, like, I've watched you do what you're doing. I want to let you know that.
Oh, thank you.
And you have a library of the people that are doing something right now.
Mm-hmm.
And you have their full nudes.
I do.
Isn't that amazing?
It is.
You ever
amazing.
Feel like blackmailing one of these
people? I mean, like,
bitch, I will release your nude.
Audience, we're not recommending that.
right.
Like, you know, I thought and I said.
Because that's not such a good idea.
I thought and I said, you know, after I shot with Jose, I was like, yo, what the fuck? I just got naked.
Mm-hmm.
I got naked for the camera, and I said, wow. And then you know what I said? I said, holy shit. Jose is doing, like, a time capsule of the people of, like, the Florida creatives.
Yeah. And so many have come and
that
shot
with me. That is amazing, Jose. You have this work from all of us.
Yep.
Like, something that means something, because Jose is not going to throw something that doesn't mean nothing.
No.
Like, he's captured our moment. And like he says, he did do, like, several types of moments.
Yeah.
But the moment that actually reflects us, he has it. He has it. And it's not cheap to have it.
But it's worth having.
It's worth
like
having.
That collection of having all of us, of the people that been in our network for so long. Like, mm-hmm. We've done so many things.
Yeah. I've done over 300 shoots in 4 years. And I can tell you that every shoot has a story. Every shoot has a situation. There's a time period that everybody was in at that time. I've shot people who right before, well, because of the shoot, they got married. I've shot people who have tragedy that they're getting over. I've shot people with body issues that when they leave the shoot, they no longer have the same body issues because they took that step. Mm-hmm. And then I have people who came in thinking they knew what they were doing, And then we got to deconstruct that a little bit and then reconstruct something new. And we found something new from inside of them. So it's really just a blessing to have that, to have the experience of it. And yeah, I've got this catalog, but I tell people the art already happened. You get a picture of a millisecond of the art that already happened. Only me and that person got the art, and you'll never have it. You just kind of get the aftermath of it. And I think that's really beautiful. I think it's wonderful when people invest that time in themselves. And my job is to create a trusted place where that stuff can reside, the stuff can sit. And over the years, we release it little by little with mutual consent. Yeah.
So one last question that I have. What advice do you give to someone who has never had a professional shoot, is probably really uncomfortable with their body, or, you know, has self-esteem issues, as a lot of us do, or like scars or whatever the case is? What is the one best piece of advice that you can give to that person?
Do a shoot like this, but don't go in with the mindset that you're going to be completely naked. Go in with ideas that don't involve nudity, but that dress you down as you go. And then don't feel the pressure to get to the end result. If at the end you can't get completely naked, it's completely okay. With me, it's more important that you feel safe and you feel good about what you did, that you don't have to go home and apologize for what you did. If you want to bring your significant other, bring them. I'm one photographer, does not care.
You just want it to be authentic.
I just want to be authentic, and I want it to be safe, and I want somebody to be proud of what they've done. So come in with that mindset that, yeah, I want this, but I don't really have an end result to it. It's kind of like sex and not expecting the orgasm. Just don't worry about the orgasm. Just worry about the experience.
No, thank you. No, please. No, please. Please.
Listen, Jose. I just want to let you know that it was like an energy connection with you when we shot.
Thank you.
You know, because it was like at that time in my life, and I said, you know what? I'm going to rebrand myself, because the whole time that I was branding myself, I was trying to make others comfortable along my ride.
Yeah.
And guess what? It didn't work out.
Yeah.
Because I didn't put myself first.
Yeah.
You know? And the moment that I did, my life started changing.
That's great.
And when you came to me and said, you know, let's do this, you know, I said, you know what? I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this because this is a new chapter in my life. I am a worthy person.
You are.
And I am a worthy woman.
Absolutely.
And I said, and I'm proud of everything about me. So I'm ready to take on this new chapter in my life. And I shot nude, butt naked. Like, you know, I just went butt naked real quick.
Yes, you did.
And I said, you know what?
No trade secret.
I don't give a fuck. Because you know what?
Amazing job.
I'm ready to take over the fucking world.
Yes.
That's what I said, because I deserve it. You know what I mean? Yeah. I'm a good person. I care about the community. And, you know, now is my job to bring us all together like we're supposed to be. And I'm ready for that, too. You know what I mean? But I want us all, like, you know, the people that are making things happen to be known. Because guess what? We're ignored all the time. So now that's where we're coming from.
Well, this will get somebody's attention for
sure. Oh, for sure. For sure.
Oh, my God.
So real quick before we sign off here,
Frankie wants to get naked now.
No. Oh, no.
She ain't ready for that.
Oh, wait, 59.
I mean, not today, but like in the future.
Our Instagram reaches 100 followers, okay? Chopping it up _
Flow Ohio. No.
Fine.
100 followers?
Instagram,
how
chopping
many
it up.
Do you want,
_
We could do about 100,000, maybe, huh?
Okay,
hold 100,000 on. We just started.
On each page. 100,000 on each page.
Yeah, Trevin.
Jose will release my fucking nudes.
There you go.
Oh, wow.
Say how many?
No,
100.
I'll release 100.
I think you know what? Whoever follows the next 5 people that follow our Instagram
maybe
page,
I'll
chopping
a
it up,
copy of it and sign it. And Jose will sign
maybe,
it.
Maybe we'll
we will send you a fucking naked picture.
Shoot, I don't know whether to be Jose's lawyer or your lawyer stuff.
Picture, but follow us on social media. Jose.
Wow.
Jose, let us know where we can find you.
I like
you.
This.
How, right. I like this. Let us know where we can find you.
Is this a challenge? I will. Are you challenging everyone?
Oh, if you want my naked picture, okay. You're going to come
okay,
get
wait,
us.
Okay, wait. Let's reset.
The count, look at the countdown.
Because Jose got the power now. I signed papers, and he said a certain percentage, and we're going to get it because he has... He's probably gonna take all my transitions on my ink fully nude.
What's right. What's the actual?
And like, you gotta pay for it.
I need to know. Okay, how many?
Okay, Jose, how do we contact you?
How many followers right. do we know?
The way to contact me is real easy. Just go to my website, jgomezfineart.com.
It's been said. It's recorded.
Yeah, we got Instagram too. jgomezfineart on Instagram. jgomezfineart on Facebook as well. So jgomezfineart.com.
This is hilarious.
Yo, and don't forget to follow us, Choppin Up. _
Do it
Blow
quick. Hold on.
We
want to see the news.
If we get enough followers.
Hold on. Okay, time out. Time out. I'm cutting the music. So what's the actual number that... How many followers does the show need?
100.
100.
Thank you.
And what do we get?
100.
She wants 100.
We get one...
What is it now?
One blurry naked picture of Star.
100 after only. 100. Because, you know, but guess what? Like, if you want to see me naked and continue seeing me naked, you're going to have to go to...
That's fucking hilarious.
His Instagram or something. Because I'm going to continue shooting all my transition of my ink. Because I'm going 75% coverage. And I'm going to be naked with it. And
so
Jose
she's
going to
be have 0% coverage on
and
her 75%
you have to go and pay for it, motherfucker.
Right. What's the math? Actual math.
That's it. I'm running all back and I'm doing an image right away.
Once again, we find Jose at J Gomez Fine Art on Instagram. You can follow me, Frankie, at The Real Frankie Fingers. And Star, where can we find you?
At Star Shear.
Yeah, yeah.
And all everything Star Shear. Thank you so much, Jose.
You're welcome.
You
Thank
are
you.
A magnificent person.
Thank you.
You know why?
You too.
Because you're returning a lot to a lot of people in so many ways.
Thank you.
And I want to say, like, the first time, like, after our shooting, everything has been unstoppable for me.
That's so great. Aww. That is so Aww. Great. That means so much. I just want to say one thing, though, but to Frankie. Frankie, go like this. Go like this.
That's a great move.
I can't believe he said that.
You had that in the hip pocket the whole
time.
That
was crazy. Well played. Well played.
All right, guys, we really got to wrap it up. Like, for real, this time we're typically Hispanic, you know. Anyways.
You know, we always say we're always freaking leaving early. Thank you so much for tuning in. You guys have to come and follow us and link, shoot on our link. Hear it again, how it sounds in real life.
Go
you
ahead.
Know, for the ones that are following us. And it was a pleasure talking to you guys today. I'm glad you guys got to learn a little bit something about my industry. And, you know, Jose Gomez, you're magnificent. Like, your
Thank
work
you.
Is everywhere and it's beautiful. Guys, you got to go on his Facebook, go on everything, see what I'm talking about. It's a different level.
Oh.
All right, y'all. See you next week.
We're going to play music on the way out. We got one more song.
Bye. Make it real thotty.
All right, so what's my name?
Oh, great show.
I'm still in Pasco, still a little Mac in these glass jokes. Still a roller roach when the cash low. Crystal knock, black gloves, black mask, letting pistols pop. Can't sing a lick, but we can whistle shots. Get the money, then it's missile drops. Making drops in expensive yachts and letting interest stop. But love and hate, that's a very fine line. And it's easily blurred with some very fine wine. Where a nigga find time to deal with all that hate? Money on the plate, yeah, we call that cake. She called round 8, I'ma call back late. And that deal you just signed, yeah, we call that rate. Me and Laws, right Peter to pay Paul. Bringing the magic back, Grand Wizard Theodore. The man in the mirror looking at who he adore. I am my Sharia Moore, I am caught in the allure. So pure, I'm sure. Miami Vice twice, big city bright light. Should've been signed twice. Top down flow, bitch, I've been this nice. This one for the money, I'm spending this twice. Miami Vice twice, big city bright light, should've been signed twice. Top down flow, bitch, I've been this nice, this one for
all the money, I'ma spend this right.
Yeah, yeah, well I'ma spend this right. Tell the DJ he should spin this right. I know she gon' spend the night. Just one for the money, I'ma spend this right. Well, I'ma spend this right. Tell the DJ he should spin this right. I know she gon' spend the night. Just one for the money, I'm spending this right.
If I'm as provocative as a Picasso or a novelist, then let it be obvious. The shit that you gotta risk is like twice your whole lifespan. Magic, mic in the mic stand. I take a shot and don't care where it might land. I'm grimy, itchy trigger finger with a side piece. I'm writing this dope on my iPhone. Call a nine piece, take a bullet for my niece. A night for my nephew, good morning. And you won't see the night, unless I let you. In Pasco, with brash flows, a bash nose, a collarbone fraction. All you hear is laughter from me. I'm Crocodile Dundee, I'm rowdy as it gets. Not as wild, one see, fuck rap. Words on my Chico mustache. We drop dirty bombs, bitch. We don't bust back, trust that. Your city evacuated, and Russell died when I rap. Diddy evaporated, I'm gone for your heart. Flown with a spark, dynamite. Fire to the blunt, let the tip be my guiding light. And we can spend this right. Tell the bartender I'ma spend this right. The rims spin tonight. Tell the stripper hoe I'ma spend this right. And she looks so nice. Tell that little bitch I'ma spend this twice.
Miami Vice twice. Big city bright light. Should've been signed twice. Top down flow, bitch, I've been this nice. This one for the money, I'ma spend this twice. Miami Vice twice, big city bright light, should've been signed twice. Top down flow, bitch, your business nice. This one for the money, I'ma spend this right.
Yeah, yeah, well I'ma spend this right. Tell the DJ he should spend this twice. I know she gon' spend the night. This one for the money, I'ma spend this right. Well, I'ma spend this right. Tell the DJ he should spend this twice. I know she gon' spend the night. Just one for the money, I'ma spend this right.
So you can run and tell that, homeboy.